Hello everyone, Fountain Pens Writing here with a new Fountain Pen review. Today we are going to take a look at the fine Writing International Mercury. Stay tuned. The pen arrives in this black box with the fine Writing International logo and the name on the bottom right. On the side you can read the nib size, in this case EF for extra fine, and the nib color, silver. In the box you can see the pen and a plastic eyedropper. The converter is inside the pen when you receive it, and it is an international standard silver color converter that matches the finish of the pen. No cartridge is provided. There was a small manual with instruction that I don't have on the hand that it is time to show you. The pen is a classic flat-top cylindrical pen. Inserted in the cap finial there is a small disc showing the company logo. The finial is divided from the cap by a small ring from which comes out the clip that has a small ball at its end. Really nice. There is a silver colored band at the bottom of the cap with the name of this model, Mercury. This pen is a part of a range of pens called planets, and this particular pen is named after the smallest planet in our solar system, Mercury indeed. The acrylic on the cap is fascinating, with its blue and white waves showing a lot of pearlescence and chatoyance. A small step and we have a perfect clear barrel divided from the finial on the bottom of the pen by another silver colored ring. The end cap is made of the same beautiful acrylic as the cap. The cap unscrews with 2¼ rotation, revealing the section made with the same acrylic of the cap, and you can see a small rubber O-ring to seal the pen when you eyedropper. The threads are quite smooth and comfortable if you hold the pen very high. The section tapers slightly, and then we have the number 6 steel yovo nib with the logo of the company on it and the EF for extra fine. Underneath the nib we have the classic yovo ABS feed. Almost like all yovo nibs, this one is also unscrewable and easily replaceable with other yovo nibs. Unscrewing the section and we have the standard international converter. But consider that this pen is made to be used as eyedropper. The Mercury is a full-size flat-top fountain pen. Here is the pen compared with the Lamy Safari Black and the Platinum 3776 White. Here they are uncapped and here posted. The pen is light and when balanced in the hand, and the material feels robust and almost premium, not a cheap acrylic by any stretch of imagination. Since the extra fine nib, I used the monolith Spencerian script with a little bit of flourishing to make this writing sample. The nib is smooth for an extra fine tip and gives a gentle and subtle feedback. Not for everyone maybe, but for me very pleasant and enjoyable. The nib leaves a western extra fine line on the paper. And this nib is really well tuned. The nib is made of stainless steel and it is stiff, so there is no point in looking for line variation. For all my writing sample I use the Waterman blue to have a consistent comparison between the nibs to see if they are dry or wet. In this case I find the nib moderately wet for an extra fine tip. Overall, this Mercury is a quite nice fountain pen, particularly if you eyedropper it and let the ink swirl in the barrel. On the other hand, both the design and the acrylic and its silver-colored finish, well, they are a bit anonymous. This particular model is out of the stock, but maybe you can find other planets, and with a price around $65, you get a good deal. Keep in mind that the treatment of the trims is not flawless, but other than that, you pay a very low price for a well-made pen. And that's all. Thank you for watching this video. If you like it, please consider to leave a thumb up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. See you soon.